Disney Pixar Storybook Collection. Toy Story 2. Hey, Woody, ready to go to cowboy camp? Andy shouted, bursting into his room. Andy grabbed his two favorite toys, Woody the cowboy and Buzz the space ranger. Never tangle with the unstoppable duo of Woody and Buzz Lightyear, he cried, linking the toys' arms together. Suddenly, there was a loud rip. Woody's shoulder had torn open. Andy's mom suggested fixing Woody on the way to camp, but Andy shook his head. No, just leave him, he said. A few days later, Andy's mom began to clean his room. She was having a yard sale and wanted to get rid of some of Andy's old toys. Andy's mom grabbed Wheezy the penguin and brought him into the yard. Woody was shocked. He couldn't let her give his friend away. Woody whistled for Andy's dog, Buster. He climbed onto the dog's back and the two raced outside to save the penguin. Woody tied Wheezy to Buster's collar, but Woody couldn't hold on with a broken shoulder. He fell off Buster and was picked up by a strange man. Uh-oh, it's Al. The man's name was Al. When no one was looking, he hid Woody in his coat. Then he hopped into his car and drove away. Buzz saw what happened from the window. He ran after the car, but he was too late. Sorry about that, folks. Anyway, all Buzz saw was the car's license plate and a few feathers floating through the air. Woody was gone. Buzz knew he had to get Woody back. He was trying to figure out who had taken the cowboy when an ad came on for the TV for Al's Toy Barn. The man on TV was dressed like a chicken. Buzz remembered the feathers and the car's license plate. LZTYBRN. Al must have taken Woody. Meanwhile, Al took Woody to his apartment. As he left, a packaging crate burst open. A cowgirl doll named Jessie and a toy horse named Bullseye popped out. It's really you, Jessie shouted. Woody was confused. Why were the toys so happy to see him? Let's show him who he really is, said an old prospector doll named Pete. Bullseye turned up the lights, revealing items carrying Woody's picture. Posters, magazines, lunchboxes, plates, and toys. Then Jessie turned on an old TV show called Woody's Roundup. Woody could hardly believe his eyes. He was the star. Prospector Pete explained that Roundup toys had become valuable collectibles. Now that Al had a Woody doll, he was selling the complete set to a museum in Japan. Oh, no. Woody can't be sold there. Back at Andy's house, Buzz and the toys set out to rescue their friend. As the sun rose, they spotted Al's toy barn, but it was on the other side of a busy road. The toys hid beneath traffic cones and dashed across the street. Inside the toy barn, Buzz found an amazing display of new Buzz Lightyear toys. Each one was wearing a super utility pack. Buzz was reaching for one of the utility of one of the utility packs when a hand grabbed his wrist. It was a new Buzz Lightyear toy. The toy thought he had caught a runaway space ranger. New Buzz quickly tied Buzz to a box and placed him on the back of a and placed him back on the shelf. Meanwhile, the other toys had found Al's office. Listening to him on the phone, they realized that Al planned to sell Woody. The toys climbed into Al's briefcase. Spotting new Buzz, they called him to join them. They didn't know that he was, they didn't know he wasn't their Buzz. Elsewhere, the real Buzz broke free. He followed his friends. But Buzz was being followed, too, by the evil Emperor Zurg. Oh, no. Not Zurg. Not far away, Woody's arm had been repaired. He looked brand new. He was ready to go to the museum. But Woody didn't want to be sold. He wanted to go home to Andy. I belonged to a little girl once, said Jessie sadly. Oh, yeah, her name was Emily. She played with me every day until she grew up. Then she gave me away. Even the greatest kids outgrow their toys. Woody began to worry that Andy would forget about him, too. Maybe it was better to go to the museum. As Woody and Jessie talked, Andy's toys arrived at Al's apartment. Woody was confused. There were two Buzz Lightyears. There's no time to explain. Come on, Woody. Let's go, the real Buzz said. But to his amazement, Woody refused. The Roundup gang needed him to make a full set. And what if his shoulder broke again? Would Andy still want him? Somewhere in that pad of stuffing is a toy who taught me that life's only worth living if you're being loved by a kid, Buzz told Woody. I traveled all this way to rescue that toy because I believed him. But Woody still refused to go. As the toys turned to leave, Woody watched a small, smiling boy on the TV. It made him realize how much he missed Andy. Hey, Buzz, wait! He shouted. He started to follow his friends, but the prospector blocked the way. He had spent his whole life in a box, and he was ready for the museum. At that moment, the toys heard footsteps. Al was coming. Al packed Woody and the other Roundup toys in a case and dashed out the door. Andy's toys followed behind, but as they headed for the elevator, they heard an evil laugh. Ha 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 ha! It's me! It's Zurg! Gasped Rex. Panicked, the dinosaur closed his eyes and turned away. Thwack! His tail knocked Zurg over. Rex had defeated Zurg. Andy's toys opened the elevator's emergency hatch. Slinky hung down to grab Woody, but the prospector yanked Woody back down. A moment later, the elevator doors opened, and Al hurried outside with the Roundup gang still in the case. Al was getting away. Luckily, Mr. Potato Head spotted a truck nearby. The toys jumped in and set off for the airport. They found Woody at the check-in desk. As Al's bag thumped onto the conveyor belt, the toys jumped on beside it. Thousands of boxes, bags, and suitcases swept past them. But Buzz kept his eye locked on Al's green case. Buzz ran along the conveyor belt. Finally, he reached Woody. But when he opened the bag, it was the prospector who popped out. Pow! He hit Buzz. Buzz fought back. Soon, he had tied the prospector to a passing backpack. Meanwhile, Woody and Bullseye managed to get out of Al's bag, but Jesse was still trapped inside. Woody followed the suitcases onto the plane. He searched the bags until he found Jesse. Just then, the plane began to move. They had to get off. The pair found a hatch and crawled down onto the plane's wheels. Suddenly, Buzz and Bullseye rode up. Woody lassoed his pull string to a bolt on the wheels. He grabbed Jesse's hand, and they both daringly dropped onto Bullseye's back. They were safe. A few days later, Andy returned from cowboy camp. When he saw the new toys on his bed, he was thrilled. But he was even happier to see Woody. He couldn't wait to play with all his cowboy toys. Someday, Andy would grow up. Maybe he wouldn't always play with his toys, but Woody and Buzz knew there's no place they'd rather be. Besides, they had each other. To infinity and beyond. So remember, everyone, if you're wondering where the best place to be is, well, the best place to be is home with your family and friends. See you later. Bye.